The impact of internet shutdowns is really huge. Switching off the internet means a total disruption of people's daily activities, their rights, and then their lives.
Myanmar, India, Chad, and Ethiopia. These four countries saw the longest major internet disruptions worldwide in 2020. Between them, lasting a total of about 23,500 hours. Digital privacy group Top 10 VPN recorded 93 major shutdowns in 21 countries. These affected 268 million people and cost the world economy over $4 billion. In the world's largest democracy, India alone, over 1,600 hours of internet blackouts and 7,200 hours of bandwidth throttling. The cost to that economy was at least $2.7 billion. Digital rights activists say governments are increasingly resorting to shutdowns in times of crisis, justifying them on the grounds of national or public security and stopping the spread of misinformation. But campaigners against shutdowns say the consequences for populations can be extremely severe, including limiting access to life-saving information during a pandemic.
What makes these shutdowns really worrying is the fact that the pandemic has forced offline activities online. And so when governments intentionally disrupt internet access to people, it denies them the opportunity to continue their education online, continue their businesses online, access life-saving information about the pandemic and what precautionary measures they can take to keep safe. When the internet is shut down during an election, people in these countries are denied their right to actively participate in electoral processes, while those outside of the country cannot scrutinize what's happening. And that's an attack on a democracy, and it hurts human rights.
In Belarus in August, large swathes of the internet, including social media, became inaccessible for days during a crucial election. Violent conflict in northern Ethiopia raged in November, little of it seen by the outside world, after authorities imposed a communications blackout. And in 2021, authorities in Uganda shut down the internet for about 100 hours in the lead-up to a disputed election. Some social media sites there remain blocked, and for rice business owner Elizabeth Nadunga, it's brought sales to a near halt.
I've really been affected so much by the shutdown of social media. I cannot run any social media advertisements. Even if I do, I have to first access the VPN, which is actually so costly and it's illegal. Previously, at least I would get like 8 orders from social media, but right now I can even go past 2 days without any order. This is really so bad for a small startup like mine.
People have lost educational opportunities, investment opportunities, lost their relationships and their mental health. We do know of regional and international blocs like the United Nations and the African Union having passed resolutions condemning internet shutdowns as a violation of human rights. Yet governments continue to impose shutdowns despite their glaring impacts. And unfortunately, we have ISPs that also facilitate these shutdowns by complying with the orders that they receive from the governments. For you and I, we definitely have an important role to play. Citizens must join the fight against internet shutdowns.